Amazing, Laura. Even when I foresee your movements, you counter me instantly.
I couldn't do it without Hazel's power. What about you? I don't see you using Mithra's hidden ability.
And what if we did?
Well, if you did, I'd just have to bring out my original blade.
Master Adam. Your evening meal is ready for you.
Oh, is it that time already?
The days are so long at this time of year. I just start losing track.
Oh, finished already? That's a shame. I was hoping to join in.
Join in? By yourself?
His Majesty has many pressing matters to attend to. Besides, I'm used to working alone.
A driver and blade are one in body and soul. That's their very nature. You're not at full strength without him.
It's not so simple as all that. I know I've yet to unlock the depths of your power.
Really? I feel like I've been giving it my all.
But you never stop growing. At any rate, Haze's ability to restrict other blades is indispensable. It's perfect for training. We're lucky.
When she stops me using my foresight, it's certainly difficult.
Oh, but you honor me too much. I'm just happy to help you both in any way I can.
Next to each other like that? You really do look like twins, you two.
It's rare for the driver's nature to appear so strongly in their blade.
People tell me that from time to time, but is it really true?
Perhaps. But whatever the reason, I am happy if I look even a little like you, my lady.
We're even the same dress size.
Right?
By the way, we want to try taking you on next, Jin.
Well, how about it, Jin?
I'm afraid I don't particularly like fighting.
And to think we're hearing that from the strongest man in Torna.
But perhaps there's truth in those words. After all, he, or rather, they...
My lord, my lady, we've discovered Malos's target. The capital.
What? Are you sure?
Yes, no doubt about it.
Who are you?
I am Fan Lenorn, envoy for the Indoline Praetorium.
Hi.
You are Rex, am I correct? Praetor Amalthus requests an audience. Please, come with me.
You're joking, right? What would the Praetor want with me?
The Praetorium manages every blade and driver in Alrest. And, as you are the driver of the Aegis...
The Praetorium wants that power for itself.
Not at all, my lady. The Praetor would like to meet his fellow Aegis driver. He wishes to speak to Master Rex. That is all.
His fellow... You don't mean...
Indeed. The Praetor is Malus's driver. There is another matter. I believe you currently have a certain dagger in your possession?
You know about that?
Why, yes. I can tell. The Praetor is its original owner, after all.
So the Praetor, he's Cole's driver as well?
Yes. Come off it.
Just how old is he?
The current Praetor is Indoline. It's not that hard to believe.
The Indoline do live long lives.
Oh, right. Well, that would explain why Cole said the dagger's owner would know how to get to the World Tree.
Well, what do you say? You certainly won't regret it. An audience with Praetor Amalthus is an honor.
Wait a second.
I wouldn't buy it, Trax. This is too good to be true.
What do you think, Mithra? You noticed, right? As soon as we met Cole?
Yes. Though I had no idea that man had become the Praetor, of all things.
Should we?
There's a lot I want to ask him. I want to know about what happened after I went to sleep. And, of course, how it is that you happen to be here, Fan.
All right, then. I want to meet him, too. In fact, we might have no other choice.
Ace.
Lady Mithra, what are you doing out so late? Can't you sleep? At this time of year, the nights can be bitter. Please don't catch a cold.
I'm a blade. We don't exactly catch colds.
Of course. My apologies.
Hayes, you really don't remember?
Hmm? I'm afraid you have me mistaken. I am Fan Lenorn, blade to Praetor Amalthus.
Right. Amalthus. Sorry, my mistake. You just reminded me of somebody I know. It is quite cold, isn't it? I might go back to my room, after all.
Yes. Good night, Lady Mithra.
Night, Fan.
Mithra, did you see her core crystal's shape?
I saw. That's not normal resonance.
It's not like with us and Rex, either.
I guess this is one more question for the Praetor. Sorry. Let's change over it, I have to think.
Sure. No problem.
Welcome back to more Xenoblade Chronicles 2. And I don't know about you, but everything that we just saw kicking everything off with this new chapter, whole time, I'm just like, wait, Fan and Myth, like, knowing each other? And then I'm like, wait, Jin's here? And then the Praetor is Malice. I remember that I freaked out like 5 different times watching that for the first time, where I'm freaking out, thinking, whoa, that's one hell of a question. And then, like, it gets followed up by another and another and another and another, and I just got comboed by the end of that cutscene and had no idea what to feel. We are kicking things off with so many questions here. You can now summon Mithra or Pyra, depending on Rex's requirements. To switch them out of battle, go to the main menu, characters, Pyra, Mithra, and press Y. During battle, you can switch between them by pressing the button assigned to Pyra and Mithra's blade switch icon. Unlike with a regular blade switch, there's no cooldown timer for changing between Pyra and Mithra, so feel free to switch it up whenever. Immensely, immensely helpful if you ever just need a specific blade combo route. No consequences for fire and light as long as Rex is in the party. One of the best things you can do in my book is enable talking to party members outside, just inside of gameplay, really. Fan has special power that easily defeats dangerous Torna fighters. Poppy quite intrigued. Is special power like that normal in Indal? Tora a bit worried about Datapon and Lila, but Tora stay with Rexrex. Especially now Rexrex invited to meet most special person in Indal. Rexrex even more amazing than Tora thought. I gotta come out and say this. Why were you not Lila? Ugh, I'm sorry, Poppy, I like you very much. Poppy, you are so, so wholesome. But I don't get it why they just gave us Poppy again, and she changes between these two different forms as though they're two different blades, even though they're not. I don't know. I thought Lila was going to be the next party member all that time ago, and I don't get why she doesn't join us at all. Even if they didn't really want to make her a major character in the story, I get that. We had Rock join us, and they sure didn't do that for him. They could have done that just fine. And I don't know. It felt really unsatisfying to me, Poppy Cutie. It's yet another thing that I'm not a fan of in the Artanian Titan gameplay-wise. I imagine that you must have been through much. I was surprised to see how much you had all grown since our encounter in Torregoth. You fought splendidly as allies as well. Perhaps you are beginning to truly make the Aegis's power your own. I must say, I never expected to be traveling on the same vessel as the Aegis and her driver. Worry not, I have no hostile intentions toward you at present. That's not a good word choice, Morak. I don't feel like I would be able to sleep at night with you saying that. Rex, you should be careful when things fall into place too easily. I know we were headed to Indol anyway, but something smells fishy about this to me. And I don't like how that Flamebringer woman's still following us around either. To think that Malus's driver was none other than Praetor Amalthus. But why would his eminence allow Malus to do as he pleases without reproach, I wonder? I suppose the only way to find out is to speak to him in person. This ship does not have a map available. Skip traveling is completely disabled for possibly the very first time. It's very open, yet here, I guess they just didn't want to make it so you couldn't come back. Master Rex, there is still quite some time left before we reach Indol. And I am sure you must be tired after all you went through in Mor'ardain. Perhaps you would like to rest a while? I'm ready for a good night's sleep.
Is it working?
Yes. I can hear the blades' voices now.
Come with me. Akos has found something very interesting.
Very well.
Hey, look at this.
Temperantia. Rumor had it that Mor'ardain were conducting an excavation there. So I thought I should check it out and,
It's changed a lot, but this shape... That's a Judicium Titan weapon.
Judicium? I know that name.
Right. It was destroyed. A casualty of the Aegis War. And it's where the Flesh Eaters were created.
Is that so?
What now?
If it's a threat to us, it should be destroyed. Or, we could make use of it.
Damn it all! I can't believe this!
Hello, Petroka. And a very good day to you, too. Don't tell me.
No, don't worry about that. We got the goods, no problem.
Well, that's something. So, why the temper tantrum?
And that's how it went down. Long story short, we had to make a run for it.
And you're sure it wasn't your ether field that was disturbed?
A female blade from Indol.
Jin, it's Haze. No doubt about it. Jin?
Mikhail, how goes the work on the Marsanis?
Oh, that's no problem. It'll take a little longer than I thought, but we'll get there.
And Akos? Where's the Aegis right now?
Near the Letherian Archipelago. She's on the move, maybe on a ship.
Maybe they're heading for Indol.
Hmm? Where are you?
Temperantia. To buy some time.
What about the Aegis? If that man gets into her head...
Not happening. That's not how Mithra works.
In fact, she'll be a big help to us. After all, only an Aegis can open up the path to the World Tree. Malus, there's a lot of work to be done on what we got from the Guild. You guys, stay here and help Mikhail. I'll go to Temperantia. Alone.
Fine by me.
Very well. Take care of yourself.
That guy.
Amazing. It looks like a mountain of clouds.
The Leftherian Archipelago. Indol is currently positioned beyond the cloud ridge. It would take quite some time to sail around. So we'll be traveling overland from here.
I suppose not even a Titan ship could surpass such an obstacle.
If we have to walk, we'd best get moving now.
It's been a while.
Must be 5 years.
Rex, have you been here before?
It's where I grew up. Me and Gramps are from Fonset Village, just over the ridge here.
I wouldn't have pegged you for Leftherian.
So this is your home.
Welcome to the Leftherian Archipelago, one of my personal favorite locations in all Rest.
Well, I guess it'd be quickest for me to lead the way from here. We just need to get over the ridge, right?
Indeed. The delegation from Indol will meet us there.
Roger that.
We'll leave it to Rex. Lead the way.
Ha ha!
Don't get an inflated head. We're just following the islands, you know?
Hey, it's still dangerous. There's a lot of tough monsters around these parts.
Well, I won't deny that.
So how are we going?
What about Fonset?
What about it?
Will we pass it?
I mean, we could go that way.
Let's do it. I mean, let's visit your village.
Okay, calm down.
Someone's rather excitable.
Not like normal, Pyra.
Don't you want to see the place where Rex grew up?
Sure, but I'm not getting my ears in a twist.
Actually, that's not a bad idea. That route's probably one of the safest we could take. How about it?
I'll leave the decision to you.
Then let's do it! We'll head off as soon as we're ready.
Yeah!
Hey. What are you still doing here, anyway?
I volunteered to come along. I'm acting as a representative of the Empire. Is there a problem?
No, not at all. The Praetorium has extended an invitation to the Aegis. We would not wish to conceal this information from the other nations.
Oh, yes. That's the Praetorium for you. Impartial to the last, eh?
Indeed.
That's not a problem for you. Is it, Nia?
Sure, we're best friends now. I'll get over it throwing me in jail one day.
Now, my lady. Morag and Brigid are on our side. That's much safer than the alternative.
Yeah, I suppose.
Come on, Nia, lighten up. It was all a big misunderstanding. They helped us out and everything, remember?
You're such an idiot sometimes.
I'm an optimist.
Call it what you want. You're still an idiot. Ugh. Okay, fine. It's water under the bridge. Go on. Friends, yeah?
Very well. Friends it is.
Actual justification for them to go to the new location of this chapter. And not just going somewhere because it's cool and because they need you to visit Mor Ardain for plot reasons, even though the characters don't have much justification for going. And not only that, but also exploring the thin ice that we've been with the Empire for so long with Nia and Morag. I like that. The part of me complaining is over. It's all water or clouds under the bridge now. let's go into our menu right away while the song plays out. Morag! Now that we know that she is actually with us to stay, I'm sorry I have attachment issues when it comes to drivers joining with only one blade and having really good skills on the beginning of their affinity charts. We have no real need to get more, no ability to get more, I don't really care about Aether. My next goal is going to be getting up to ultimate footwork to boost her agility by 10%. Again, agility is a huge deal. Dodging attacks altogether a lot better than guarding against them if you can. This potentially can make Morag not dependent on healing. These I don't care about, and those... I suppose Imperial First Aid could be helpful in some situations if we just aren't able to stay alive in a fight, which was the case before, admittedly, but I cared more a lot about this. Going into Brigid, I didn't update her courtship last time, I did everything else. She's a unique weapon class, the Dual Whip Swords. We've seen these in action a lot. Believe me, my face is very familiar with how they work. But she has good damage for keeping aggro, a high block rate, and actually a pretty decent base critical rate as well. It's a very all-around good weapon class. With the Magna Chip, she can get higher stats in the critical and auto attack with 50 more strength on Morag, but at the cost of her block rate. A lot of people like going all in on dodging, all in on blocking, so that whenever Brigid does happen to get hit, it's not very much damage and the enemy is gonna plink right off. This is a good way to go, but personally, I think going in on damage is a better way to go on Brigid. She evades attacks altogether so often and has that perfect evasion art that as long as she's played as, this is good. Playing as Brigid is the optimal way to be, and we're gonna be doing that for a while with these muscle whips. And I can totally go for this, her weapon's still looking cool. Now, Morag being a party member is a pretty hard thing to avoid talking about, and it would be a pretty big spoiler for newcomers to the game. If I had to pick one thing that I like the most about the Xeno fandom, it's how courteous they are to new players about spoilers, wanting them to experience these stories as intended. As such, I will pass on to you from one Xeno fan to another that it's common courtesy to refer to Morag as the number 4 when talking about her online or in public places. In the way of pouch items, we've already seen that Brigid likes desserts. Morag likes, which one's it gonna be?
Good choice. I happen to be quite fond of these.
Gotta eat her spinach to keep her strength up. And hey, some she and Nia can talk about as they work out their differences.
Thank you. I will be sure to treasure it.
Her favorite?
Ah, an exquisite fragrance that soothes the soul.
You didn't teach me how to pronounce it. I'm guessing Quoteletta? That just sounds like Cacoletta's awkward cousin who's very concerned about punctuation, but... I don't know, Quoteletta? Maybe? Quoteletta? I don't know! They don't teach us anything besides America in history class around here. And then her other favorite item.
This is the pride of Mor Ardain. How wondrous to behold.
Indeed it is. Both of these items are purchasable in Alba Cavendish. The love of Brigid's life.
This is quite a boon. So organic and creamy. We should stock up on this.
Starting with higher base affinity, getting the buff from both liked item and favorite item is quite good. It could actually free up one of her ox cores for not having Hunter's Chemistry if that is desired. Still not gonna do it though.
Delicious. I'll have to write this down.
Another good blade who does good damage and has dessert as a... It has dessert as a liked item to keep the pressure up. Next up, I want to go into the Merc group, as it's been a while since I've done anything with this feature, as I don't do this if, That's a thing that we can do now. Azami has a Merc mission that she has unlocked now that Morag is in the party. That was a prerequisite for a certain quest that is unlocked that way. Stolen data. This is that Noog Skeeter quest that we did a long time ago where we had to get the papers out of its belly. This Merc mission is exclusive to that quest, and you can do it this way, but you get a worse reward out of it. I was kind of remiss to not mention it earlier, unfortunately. It doesn't change the quest in a meaningful way, you still kill the same enemy. The only difference is that it has a quest marker above its head, you don't have to brute force it, or get lucky in one try like I did. Animals and Great Axes can get some nice, trade going with Argentum and Mor Ardain. Let's get that going. Burn wanted posters has... It seems some wanted posters for rebel groups have been burned. It's obvious who is responsible. I'm not admitting to anything. We'll get this HP attack boost. That's all good to go. So as soon as we switch Mithra in, let's boogie. Esasa! Meh-meh-meh-meh! Esasa thought would never make it back alive! Is something the matter? Esasa was on way to Fonset when on business errand. When all of a sudden, Esasa lose footing in on narrow road and slip into Cloud Sea. Esasa managed to noppy paddle to safety on small island, but was great struggle to reach surface again. Friends have bigger bodies than Esasa, so should watch steps even closer. We'll keep that in mind. I'll be sure to watch my big body as it's flailing all over the place. Right under here is a very well-hidden treasure chest that I don't believe I found until pretty recently, actually. We get another gauntlet from there, an accessory that I'm a decently big fan of. And we have Nora to talk to. Oh, hello. Whew, that was a proper struggle. I should never have taken that right-hand route. Is something wrong? Oh, if you leave this port and head to Baltados Island, the path splits in two. The path on the right is just teeming with scary monsters. I'd stick to the left path if I were you. Thanks. What she says is absolutely true. We actually have two pathways that we can take to get to Fonset Village. Here we can see two main story quest markers. This will happen from time to time. It is 100% up to you where you want to go. The right of those two paths is a lot more challenging. It can get very, very tough. The left path has got one tough fight against a specific unique monster that I have an awkward history with, but we'll get to that when we get to that. It's up to you which way you want to go. You could also avoid that one fight and not have to worry about it. Now, I have no idea what it is with this series and sticking testicles on birds' faces. Yes, that's a real sentence that I really, really have strong opinions about. Don't judge me, but Boomahilns are a monster that Mithra wants to kill for her affinity chart, so let's take those out right here and now. We use Break, and there is one special of Bridget's that we were not able to see in the previous battle. Her level 3! Just in time for me to not do it, Joe. Level 3! I have to kill this Puffot just because it got in the way? This thing is adorable! I hate beating up all these beautiful baby birds. I feel so sorry for him.
Won't be that easy.
What? Whenever Mamorak gets hit with a strong attack, it's so funny. Just flying through this super serious, humorless person, flying through the air, and then what? Ooh, launch heat! Launch heat! No! As she flails her arms at nothing. They managed to make Bridget look like a dumbass right in front of Mithra, too. Her level 3 special is called Swirling Dragon. It is a physical attack. It has a 25% critical chance increase. And if Bridget's HP is low, it makes her stronger. Given that she has increased evasion chances when her HP is low, she's also a good desperation attacker when it looks like a battle is about to be lost. One of the reasons that I note the number of hits that specials have, in this case 11, is because that high critical hit chance is significantly better with attacks that hit multiple times. The Puffet dropped a flower chip, the Puffot dropped a flower chip. This is a good chip right away. Could help out a lot of blades, not you. Mithra, ooh, that looking good. But what else could I get? Mithra's looking like the clear choice here. Sucks losing a little bit of critical hit rate, but that is a nice gain to her auto attack stat. Oh. No, I'll take the magnet chip and give dexterity. Not a particularly helpful buff, but that's the name of the game sometimes. Sometimes the stats that you want have effects that are attached, but they aren't specifically helpful. It can just be all about the stats if you want. Things have a funny way of working themselves out. Dromark is factually better from this, and since we're forced to use him anyway for a healer, we might as well make him better. When I skip-traveled, I noticed Gamel's here now. Have you heard anything interesting lately? You were passengers on board that ship from Morardane, weren't you? Are you headed to Fonset? You'll need to pass through one of the Cloudways then. There are two paths you could take. Cloudway is the closer one, but the route's full of things not meant for your eyes. If I were you, I'd take the Oral Cloudway instead. Ew. Ugh, we don't get a say in the matter. We're either doing oral or getting lewd.
The time to display our skills. We're all
wood chip! The Hilns drop wood chips! Oh, that's what's inside those balls. Don't have anyone in mind for these right now, but that is good to know. Very helpful item that hasn't been too easy to get. I had a bubble in my throat. Here we go! Level 3! I actually got it! Boom, 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 using your arms like a machine gun! It's what I would do if I had dual swords in my hand. I would just swing them as fast as I could. That had to smart. Lightning Buster, level 2.
Nice work, everyone.
Woo!
The power to do what needs to be done.
And just right over by the ship is a salvaging point. May I get this right in one try? Because it's all I have.
Oh, I can't wait.
Rex, if you could use that ability in battle, it'd be very helpful. You wouldn't even need Mithra's foresight. You'd have 100% evasion.
I'm back. Miss me?
Ha! You holding out on us? A white cover. I'm pretty sure that Dromark has another one of his skills that wants to get items from salvaging. Does he? Maybe? Possibly? At this level? I don't, but perhaps you do. There's a nice, easy salvaging point to do that on. And just beside the salvage point, let's take a dip. Showing off our great big old bodies. Hello-lo. See, Mama come here for just search for tasty, tasty juice ingredients, but only find lots of cloud sea. Other brother ponds and sister ponds probably find ingredients and go back home to Argentum already. What should see Mama do? You don't look too outfitted for salvaging. You wouldn't be able to last 5 minutes. Try gathering from a Titan. Meh, meh, meh. Oh, see Mama not even notice the Titan right there behind see Mama. Titan even covered in greenery. Probably full of tasty, tasty veggies. See Mama will find ingredients and take ship straight back home. Drop by 12 Brother Sister Pond. Drinks place at Argentum if friends want. And say hello to see Mama again. Bye-bye for now.
Done and
it's a personal rule that I hold myself to. In the production of these videos, that once I've started recording a game, I'm not allowed to listen to the music from it until recording has wrapped. That way, I have time to miss my favorite music and have a genuine happy reaction to hearing them again. So with that said, it is my great honor to introduce you to a song that helps me feel at bliss no matter the situation. Letherian Archipelago Day. It's just such a sweeping piece, and I find it so baffling that this just didn't catch on like the other tracks in the game did. I never hear this at the list of top tracks out there, and I remember the first time I heard it, I had goosebumps, and I felt so happy. To this day, it's a song like Sticker Bush Symphony for me, honestly, where it's just something I listen to when I need to feel good.
We've been discovered.
You have a main Aluka here to break up make the atmosphere all tense again. I guess nothing can last forever. We gotta earn our beautiful music. On that note, I kind of don't like the regular battle theme of Xenoblade 2 that much. I don't know if this is an unpopular opinion. I like a lot of the battle themes, especially the boss music and the unique monsters, but not so much this one. I gotta say, not one of my favorites. It force and topple on itself. It's one of the things that's unique to this type of enemy. By doing that, it's rolling around, and it can be launched if you avoid the attack and follow up in time. You might be wondering why I'm not awakening more blades for Morag. Why am I sticking with just one blade? Well, Bridget's whole rule, where every single time that she evades an attack, Morag keeps doing more damage, that only functions that way as long as Bridget is not switched off of. Some blades, like Bridget, and as we've seen, Crossette, they have benefits if they are not switched off of and you keep them out longer longer. Over this way, after that. A blade. Smells like a quest. And it reads like one, too. It seems a little strange right away that, you know, I'm going over Bridget. We've seen her capabilities pretty well up to this point. I think I've explained her about as well as I can. But we haven't gotten any more blades for Morag, even though we have lots of core crystals and she could absolutely use more blades on her. The reason for that is I wanted to showcase that there are blades where it's good to not switch off of them. Just because you're switching blades and using more arts and all that doesn't necessarily mean goodness. In the case of Bridget, she's a fine example because that whole rule that every time Morag evades an attack, her attack or damage gets more powerful up to 250%, that only keeps adding up as long as Bridget is not switched off of it, similar to Crossette's effect. A lot of the time whenever there's your damage goes up every single time you do this, cumulative, that's how that operates. Again, how do I know this? I read it on the internet. Didn't know that in-game, had no idea how it worked, had no idea why I was never getting my damage increases seemingly no matter what I did, and I was so frustrated about it because it led me to believe that Bridget was a really bad character, and I just didn't really utilize her that much unless I wanted to dodge ranged attacks from a boss that had something really dangerous that I died to already. That was the only time that I used her on my first playthrough. So really, Morag is fine only having one blade. We could awaken more core crystals for her if we so wished, but it's not necessary at all. We get a fusion combo, I still saw it. Good! Nice! See how hard she was hitting there? We're absolutely fine. We'll awaken new blades for her soon enough. Oh goodness, thank you. You really saved me. My name is Olua. You can probably tell I'm a blade. Probably. Nice to meet you. Now that just feels insensitive. This doesn't affect anything besides flavor. Ah, you noticed. My driver is a wonderful young man named Reed. He's still a novice driver, not as strong as you. Nor is he much of a swordsman yet. So when faced with danger, he tends to run away. But a Moxaluca caught him unawares from behind and sent him tumbling down into the cloud sea. That not good. Don't worry, everything's fine. I'm still alive, so he must be too. She sounds like she's used to this. I'd be lying if I said I wasn't worried. Do you perhaps think you'd be able to look for Reed? He might be fine right now, but if he got attacked by a monster, he'd be a sitting duck. Leave it to me. Thank you. There's a chance Reed may return to under his own esteem. So I'll wait here in case he does. Before we do anything else further. Bridget unlocked her level 2.
A new trick up my sleeve.
She wants to defeat Mena Lucas. That's why you check the stuff, because you don't get the skills. That's another thing. Around this point in the game on my first playthrough, I got so tired of having to go into the menu every time I learn a new skill that I just stopped checking it and figured, oh well, I'll just pay attention to the notifications on the side of the screen. That means that up until near the end of the game, I was playing through with Bridget's skills at level 1. And that's not all. That meant that Mithra only got up to level 2 or so before I did that, and I played through the rest of the game with her like that. I was so weak, hitting for like no damage, and it didn't help that nothing was well explained on top of that. Woo! Well, maybe it won't be so hard to get these kills now with us just doing that well. Look at this. Rex getting aggro is a little bit problematic, but besides that, look at how much we're just wrecking. It's... Spoke too soon. Whoa, man, it just barfed all over me after knocking me to the floor, adding insult to injury, why don't you?
Hey, Morag, did you see me? That was a cool move, yeah?
It was a fine display of swordsmanship.
It was
I could
a
learn
breeze.
A lot from it.
All friends returned safely!
Aww, they're getting along. Not you. 3-for-1 deal. And it wasn't even the one I was shooting for. Woohoo! Whew, agate, not a git. Affinity Max Attack 2 can be gotten from Nopon Letter. And Affinity Max Barrier 2 is from Wood Gathering in Gormont. Mithra wants Neo Flamies in Letheria as well, and that can be found also on the second island. Right over there. That was just a lucky guess. I didn't have any way of knowing what that was behind that. End this. Poppy QT got her level 2 key affinity reward despite not even doing anything.
Next goal already in sight.
Ew, I'd like to replay what just happened. It toppled Morag to the ground and then spat in her face. Oh, this thing decided it wanted a piece of me during this, and it might just get it. This is bad, but you know, I think I want to try it anyway. It'll be rough, don't get me wrong. We will have a hard time with this, but our healer is dead. I was gonna say we might actually have a good fighting chance at using Bridget alone here and showcasing how strong she is. To make a long story short, nah. At least Bridget got a new skill out of the matter. Bridget wanted to get some ore for her mineralogy level 1.
I don't call you the Empire's strongest blade for nothing.
I am but a humble student of Lady Morag's greatness. Come now. Without Bridget by my side, I can hardly call myself a special inquisitor, can I?
Mithra gets level 2 of Photon Edge. It's full double rainbow all the way across the chart.
I'll show you even more.
There is still much to learn.
Level up for Morag and Will-O-The-Wisp level 2 and Swirling Dragon level 2. Any other skill ups I should know about? No.
For victory.
Bridget wanted 4 desserts for her last skill on her level 2. Here, try the churros. They're from a country I don't think you can get into.
I can guard Lady Morag ever more closely.
Anyone who lifts a finger, claw, or other such appendage against you is dead meat.
Poppy QT got level 2 on her chart, and she wants 2 pieces of artwork. Computers don't really have the easiest time understanding art, so we can just give her the same one twice, and it works fine. And then she got to snort 4 veggies. That's about all we got. Everything else is by playing normally. Was there something else that we were supposed to be doing? Oh yeah, it's kind of unlucky that they had all of these chart objectives between them and life and death. We'll hop up this way because our place that we're going is down there on that little island. The Leftherian Archipelago is so open. We could swim all around this cloud sea, go to little islands like this, maybe even go to the bases of these titans. There's not really any limits to it. There might even be some things for you to find, like this little island here. Swimming around in the cloud sea is not too important. Wow, Bridget's hair looks amazing like that. You know, Bridget's hair normally, like, I'll wait until she gets out before I finish that sentence, though. But yeah, it's very open. You can go all over the place. Any which way you want. 2 ways to your next story objectives. Bridget's hair, can I just say, it looks delicious. Like, it looks like some kind of gummy candy. And, like, the way that, like, it jiggles when she walks. I want to eat her hair. And I was that weird kid that always grew his hair out. And I'm on the wrong island, aren't I? Yeah, it's over this way. Okay, maybe open is a little bit too open for my feeble mind at times, but it doesn't change the fact that I love this place, and it's so beautiful, and it's such a creative location, how you have these floating titans that are essentially floating islands, and they're all interconnected by the civilization here, and some of them are down in the cloud sea. Such a beautiful location. Reed! Whoa, you're younger than I thought. A bit weird to meet someone here. I've lost my blade. I'm waiting here until she shows up. So the thing is, aw, what? Aluma told you to come find me! Like some little brat, huh? You okay? As you can see, I'm doing just dandy. But I don't want to go back to Aluma. She's always go on me like, trade up, get stronger. I've had enough of her nagging. Even just now, when I got knocked into the cloud sea by a Mox Aluka, sending you just proves it. She thinks I can't get back on me own. She told me we had to go on a training mission, so we've been doing some traveling. But I haven't gotten any stronger. Not a bit. And Aluma doesn't trust me at all. I don't want to be a driver anymore. Can you get back on your own? Of course not. I guess I gotta go back to Aluma. She's the worst blade ever. I've gotta give her a piece of my mind. Looks like it's time to flutter up.
Winds, lend me your transient fleeting aid.
Her design is so cool. She's made of book pages, and then she's got like this weird ethereal empty space in the middle of her and doesn't really have a torso. She's just like all these floating book pages. Oh, I love her so much. Adnane is one of the coolest looking blades to me, and I've been really wanting to compliment that about her. The thing is that I've had a lot of little things I've wanted to say about the characters and designs and story and all that. It's just that things have been go. We've been getting new blades, we've been going to new areas, having really big fights. There's just been so much going on rapid fire that I've been just playing catch up this whole time in the Lotharian Archipelago. I'm glad we have a little time to breathe. If you want to die that badly, keeping me from a quest objective is a great way to assure it.
I am but a humble student.
Aloha! Reed, I'm so glad you're all right. Sorry for worrying you. Indeed, if you trained up and got a little stronger, I wouldn't have to worry so much. No, you gotta stop with that, Alua. Didn't it just prove it? I'm no driver. Not yet. I've gotta get strong like these guys before I can go off on journeys and stuff. But training trips are how you become strong, Reed. Aye, there's a limit. Let's travel after I've learned how to sword fight and what have you. You've got it all backwards. It's like asking me to make a banquet when I can't even hold a knife. If you just put your mind to it, though, everyone's got to start somewhere. The most important thing is taking the first step. Let's talk about this later. We should be thankful to these fine people. I don't care, whatever. I'm going home. You can do your training mission alone. Young man! Here's something by way of thanks. I hope we meet again sometime and we can talk properly. Here's hoping they sort it out eventually. That's a clever idea, how a lot of blades are adults when they awaken, so you could have a situation where the kid is the boss of an adult, and that creates all sorts of problems in their relationship. Well, maybe I shouldn't tell him that the first time I ever saw the name Reed, it was in text. Every single Reed I ever met in real life was spelled E-E-D, and so for years I was calling them Red. Yeah, that was a thing I did. Anyway, we made it to the second island of the Lotharian Archipelago. And did everything we could here, getting a lot stronger in the process. Next time on Xenoblade Chronicles 2, we'll be going further into the Lotharian Archipelago. But is it this way? Or is it that way? Find out next time.
It's the dawn of a new day.
Let me read you the agenda for today.